this movie is very special because it's the third one after two others. So it's the first time I was with the same actors, but they were 25 years old. Second time they were 30 years old, so this time they're 40 years old. So the idea is really to describe their life and how it does change when you're 40 years old, with children especially.
I can't stay here. I've met someone in New York, and I'm taking the children.
Au revoir, Papa.
I have to figure out how I can see my children. Hi. I just wanted to say I love you kids.
You and I have a lot to say to each other.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For the first one, for Potluck, L'Auberge Espagnole, the idea was really to do something very quickly, very improvised, very spontaneous. It's almost the opposite today because it's really... Because it's the third episode of their life, then I had to think more about all the combinations. The idea was more to have more a script, to have more something thought out. And it was not the same thing when, you know, when they were 20 years old and they were not well-known and young actors. In a sense, it was easier because it was only with their energy that the movie worked. But this time, it was more complicated to organize things, but then they're more professional. It took me a long time to really know how to shoot this movie in New York with a different look, with a different vision, because New York is really in so many movies that it's hard when you're a director to create a new vision about that city. But I'm glad that so far the New Yorkers who've seen the movie really like the way it shot.
Are we in Chinatown?
Oh yeah.
C'est marrant que tu vois ça si compliqué la vie.
Je suis ici à New York pour pouvoir vivre à côté de mes enfants. J'ai un enfant avec deux lesbiennes. Je suis marié à une chinoise pour pouvoir être américain. Et la vie elle est pas si compliquée?
I hope everyone's life has a more simple life than Xavier, but I think life tends to be complicated. I think that for everyone it's complicated, but I think it's good to have problems. I thought it was better to create more problems to really talk about that. So what's true in life, because you need, you know, happiness and quietness and something calm, I think it's not true in movies. I think in movies you need to have drama and conflict and problems. Every country in the world are in New York, so I think it's even more true for New York than London or Paris. So this idea of melting pot, melting, mixing cultures, which is really in the three films, for me it was the city that really described more that idea of what I started with L'Auberge Espagnole, mixing different people from different cultures in an apartment, to do the same thing in a city. For me, it was more obvious in New York.
This is New York, okay? There are rules and there are rules.
You're gonna hire him just like that? He's a foreigner.
I'm a foreigner. Who's not a foreigner in this room?
It's me. He has a problem with me.
Try to understand him. He lands in a new country, I'd probably react the same way.
You're so nice.
You should also try to make a little bit of an effort.
Why are you so nice? Hey.
Justice is victorious.
I got you, boss.
À la vie. Merci.
De rien.
I would probably love to stay a long time in London also, because I don't really like London, but I like people in London. I like English people. So I'd like to spend some time here, because also the actors here are great, and I'd love to work here again.